Thank you. would have invited you. Did you put someone?
No.
Is this not confusing?
subject E, and then there's a definition. Post E, and then there's a definition. That's what I want to mention. And that if you don't know why, it's because it's not just a little bit of a definition. You have a Chinese, and you have a German. Or my definition. What's my definition in that mean? There's so many definitions about human sociality. So many definitions. So we need to refresh this select. It's like, the capacity in context means I'm selecting the definition that human resources management will help you in human development. Someone can select another three definitions that will solve human resources problem or any other thing. It's like when you talk of context, it's like this way. I always normally use this. This way is the sentence. But if I ask you what is the meaning of a sentence, you will have to find out in which context. Because in class like this one, you will tell me that a sentence is a group of words. That's all they talk. It's a group of words that makes meaning. But it is in the context of this. Or maybe you have to quote it. Someone has to run past a sentence.
Yeah.
Is that a group of words?
No.
That's what we mean by context. Yeah. So context means many ways you will be relationship. So in any one definition of understanding, it gives the context of which just try to show the relationship between human government and this. Another one can select his own definition to suit a particular context. So in our context, I'll give you three definitions. You can use them to help you in the essay, or you can ignore them, no problem. But the basic three definitions of human resources management that I normally use are one, that the human resources management is a set of practices. The form S1 manual that is defined, it's a set of practices and procedures. For the management.
That's human resources?
No, that's human resources management. Okay, and at least I'm doing this. You see the connection.
Yes.
So it's like that way. That's human resources management. And this is not, sorry, it must not be the three definitions of human resource management. Three definitions of human resource management. A set of practices, first definition. It's a set of practices and procedures for the management of the relationship. For the management of the relationship between employer and employee. Between employer and employee. That's the first definition. It's a set of practices. And this is the definition that was given by Nick Wilcox. This is the definition that was given by Nick Wilcox. This is HRM. Because if we are going to show the connection between human capital management and human resource management, we should know what human resource management is. And I've created this definition because it will help us here. This was a definition that was given by Nick Wilcox. A set of practices and procedures. And this is for the management of relationships between employer and employees. That is human resource management. That's the first definition. The practices and procedures are the regulations. Regulations plus the rules. That govern human behavior in organizations. Set of practices and procedures. So the first definition given by Nick Wilcox is very good because it includes the with practices and procedures. Last time I was making an introduction, I said that the people need the rules. We need the rules that should have in our beginning. We need the rules and procedures. So that these rules and procedures, or practices and procedures, they regulate behavior of people in organizations, human behavior. So the reason for having regulations is to make sure that there is order, there is fairness, and there is no selfishness. That's the reason why we need rules. The reason we need rules must be what? But it is also for relationship management between employer and employee. Employer versus employee. I always like this game between these two people. This one wants profit. This one wants benefit. So already there are two diverse needs. The employer needs profit, wants to make profit. The employee needs benefit. He wants better pay. He wants benefits like housing allowance, medical, transport, airtime allowance, electricity allowance, and so many education allowance. Because they need different things, and these are conflicting. You know, for you to make profit, you need to reduce the expenses. So the employer is looking for reducing the expenses. This one is looking for increasing benefits. Labor contract doesn't bad. I can tell you, employer and employee, they don't see each other face to face. I'm a man, silently, for my family. We hope I'm not going to reduce the expenses. We hope I'm going to increase the benefits. In a, I'm a teacher here, I'm here. My employer is here, wants to reduce the expenses. When I need increase. This one is looking for reducing. Now, because of that, human resource management has to manage this relationship. So when we are managing this relationship, maybe we are doing human resource management. And your job, one chief, you will remember this, one of your duties will be to manage the relationship with your family. To the extent that sometimes you appear as if you are not part of the organization. No one can be well. You are not a part of management and you are not a part of the lower side. From a class struggle which is between top management and the staff. Our Namina company is the owners of the company, these are the workers. They in your human resource makeup, HR, you are here. This might help you look you at this side. Because you are so much of that side. You should be moved. So these people say, Abuana, what is the name of the amount and what is the 40% salary increment? Your money. Because these are for increased ability. These are for reduced expenses. For you to make a profit, you need to reduce expenses. Simple. Simple, easy. But if I have come to my employer, we know our business, and we know my chief, he wants to reduce expenses. So that he increases profit. Profit is to increase in that way. For example, if I spend 50,000 and I make 75,000, my concern is why can't I give 30,000 so that I should still make 75,000? Never gets off. Now, when you have a reduced one, you can do what you're doing. You can't reduce this time expenses without reducing. price. The price, this was in 2007. A certain gentleman called Price also gave a definition of human resources management. Dufuna kuti definition yokubereka maita compare ndi ma definition yokubereka ya human capital management. You will now see the connection. So Price in 2007 defined human resources management as a philosophy. Philosophy of people management, the philosophy of people management based on the belief that human resources are uniquely important, in achieving organizational effectiveness and efficiency. That is the second definition of human resources management. A very important definition as well. It is a philosophy of people management. Now, a philosophy is a way of thinking. Philosophy means organization. It's a way of thinking. So, Mr. Price, in 2007, defined it as a philosophy. It is a philosophy of people management. And it is based on the belief. So it's a way of thinking of people management. And this way of thinking about people management is based on the belief that human resources are uniquely important. Uniquely means specific or special, very special. Especially important in achieving organizational effectiveness and efficiency. So, this definition is also talking about the value of people in organizations. The contribution that people bring to the organization. That's the value. So, according to Price, we want to believe that human resources are uniquely important. In the next one, and I'll be saying it again and again, that the organizations will be effective and will be efficient when they have unique human resources of things. It's like a philosophy of human management based on the belief that human resources are uniquely important in achieving organizational effectiveness and efficiency. That's the second definition. It's a philosophy. It's a way of thinking. It's based on the belief that human resources are uniquely important in achieving organizational effectiveness and efficiency. That's the second definition that I have selected. There are so many definitions, but I've just selected that one. Because it will help us. It will help us in trying to see the distinction or the relationship between human capital management and human resources management. A philosophy, as I've said, is a way of thinking. It's the philosophy of people management. You see, there's nothing more difficult than understanding people and managing them. You told me about this dead person, and yesterday we found him, and after that he has been killed. In the same manner, of course, he was of very good course. Now, when we start thinking, what? 21 more about what has been killed. Yeah, that's right.
Two.
Because the Bible is very moral. They are not after the devil. And they are living the dead body there. And the people that are also the dead body right now, when the couples were in their house. So, people management is very difficult.
So, you take one of what is the motive? What is this that they are thinking of?
Because in the end, these things are spreading fear towards us, all of us. So, whatever come answer. Even when somebody stops to pick you in the car, no, it's only kind of a normal kind of I passed it. You see, to which I'm not. Time management is very difficult. And for me, I'm not going to say, I'm here. You can't understand. So, when is that? It also fulfills management thinking those ways, like. And for much of the belief is that human resources are uniquely important. This is very true. Right people. Because it's very important for human beings. You want to be human being, human development. What it means is right people. Right people doing the right job. An asset, an advantage, an added advantage to any organization. Right people doing the right job are the advantage of the organization. That's what it means. Because it says human resources are uniquely important in achieving organizational effectiveness and efficiency. The right people doing the right job, that's an added advantage. It's a plus. Who are the right people? The people who contribute positively to the organization. These are the right people. People who contribute by crossfire. No. It's not crossfire. It's a times exclusive program. Times exclusive. In Nigeria, I think it's last week. I'm not from the chief executive officer and Southern Region Water Board, Mr. Jim Bamba, the chief executive officer for Southern Region Water Board. I'm Afusana Fuso, the Brian Banda. Now I'm interested in one question. He asked me to make a Makala, chief executive officer for how long? He responded with 4 years. And Mr. Brian Banda asked me, what have you done in 2 years? Mabangabo done in 2 years. And the guy knew what he was done, and he said, breaks 1 year for 1 minute. I'm a photo of the Brahmin of Mabanga in 2 years. He's on the management. I'm a mobile segment of 1 hour or 2 hours in a day. We have been increased. I'm a normal myself, I'm to take up for 15 hours. Oh, Mambo, you want to sell the medium order for my dad, Mambo, you have my rest house, you have a number of roads, you have a number of hotels, I'm a banker, all car, sell the medium order for you, but we have now managed to give them water, which is well treated, and a delegate to something. That is the contribution that I mentioned. This is what we are talking about. Human resources are uniquely important for an organization's effectiveness and efficiency. The right people doing the right job are the added advantage. And to the other, if they are not the right people, then you have a problem. So the right people doing the right job becomes an added advantage. The other time, in Munda Salim, you know, in our team, we gave them a bag of meat that year, that was 2021. They spent 3 months, and I thought that was a waste. There was no efficiency, there was no effectiveness. They got me that I don't know what to do with this. I don't know what to do. So for 3 months, they were still doing the job that I thought would have been done in 1 month. So after that, I removed them. Last year, in 2005, I sent them to sell a piece of land. They have done the way it is. so that you see the right people doing the right job in an early life. You can waste a lot of resources. And you are doing in those 3 months, nothing a human can be a fool for them. But then after 5 months, not even then, 5 months, they have done it in 3 weeks. And I've told them you should wait until you plant because you have done a good job. The right people in the right position or doing the right job is an early advantage in organizations. Definition number 3, which I also want us to consider, which we can use to help us see the distinction between human capital management and human resource management, is this one. Human resource management has been defined as the art of utilizing human resources in an organization effectively and efficiently. That is human resource management. I've taken this definition, number 3, because it talks about art. HBD is that, whenever it's a philosopher. The rabbi, whenever they said of practices and procedures, they are to learn. We have just forgotten this one, but once I come to know him, I'll let you know who did this. It's the art of the utilizing, it must not be the art of the utilizing, but the art of utilizing human resources in an organization effectively and efficiently. That's human resources. Now, when you look at this and you compare the definition I gave you about human capital management, you will start to see the connection. You start to see the connection Capital management. give you some definitions, I'm sure, but we need to have a summarized definition. Summarized definition. And this is what I would like us to see, where you can see the connection. The summarized definition of human rights management is what people bring and contribute to an organizational success. Very important. What people bring, what people bring and contribute to an organizational success. Very important. That's a summarized definition. What you bring and contribute to an organizational success. That's human capital. Human capital is what people bring and contribute to an organizational success. It becomes human capital. So human capital, actually it's human capital summarized definition. We are trying to manage the contribution of people. So human capital is specific. Human capital is management, because management is now the coordination of this. But the human capital is what people bring and contribute to an organizational success. When Team Pillar, you are a player. Not from the only that sports capital. We would like to believe that they are sports capital. So OSC, if it were spending so many millions on Cristiano Ronaldo, Matibana, Cristiano Ronaldo, like Messi, Messi is still very active. There is Kylian Mbappe, and you are still, they spend a lot of money on football clubs to buy these players. What they are buying is capital. They believe that random means will lead them to that success. So when you look at what people bring and contribute to organizational success, then we are focusing on human capital. Now this is in relation to human resources management. We are also managing people. It's a philosophy of people management. They believe that people or human resources are uniquely important. So there's a connection. The other summarized definition of the human capital. Number two, human capital can also be understood as the collective value of the capabilities, the collective value. Collective value of the capabilities. Value of the capabilities, knowledge, skills, life experiences, knowledge, skills, life experiences, life experiences, and motivation of an organizational workforce and motivation. Value. Value,
many of great human beings
in so many senses. Anything to which you attach weight, you see, when attached to it, for example, the weight I can attach to this, this I can attach the weight of, because the price of something is the value. So this I can attach the weight of 65,000 the price. That's the weight I can attach to this. So now I'm dividing the weight. But to this one, I'm going, cell phone number A, cell phone number B, I'm going to attach the value of 15,000. So you can see the value is the price, which is the weight. The price of anything is the weight you attach to that thing. That's why if you lost weight a while, sometimes the number of people compared to if you lost 5,000. Because you attach weight to that, those figures. But in the weight of the money, 5,000 weight. So if you lose the weight of the money, I don't think when you spend the whole day complaining, because the weight is not much. But if you lost 5,000 weight, you will have to get consent because the weight is high. So if you want the money, when you talk about collecting value, collecting weight, how do we value, how do we attach weight to the capabilities and knowledge and skills and experience? That's why in human resources, we need to compensate weight. And for an individual, you see, there's always the belief. If we go Punjabu and in Chambuanero, or Magdalu Bridge, in Jamanamaku Bridge, Grass House, you can see the value of the people. We are Chinese, we are Africans, Malala. In a way, it's a China, in a way, it's a church. I want to know, after the number of now, surprisingly, I can only do what the MD is doing. Because weight is made of knowledge. Weight is made of, we don't put weight to money weight. If I have all system say over the system, all state, and I didn't have anything to work on it. That is capital. You get paid more for knowledge. You can learn about the formula of Coca-Cola. The genuine Coca-Cola. In the car, I'm not even going to go back to the army, actually, I'm going to get to getting paid. Where can I know this? He added his value to Coca-Cola. Because when I can come down, somebody jumped, froze, I'm going to go back to the drink, and I'm going to go back to Coca-Cola. When you just see this one, the Coca-Cola, you know. But I'm going to go back to the other side. Because you know, there has to be someone who added his value to the formula. And Coca-Cola is enjoying giving consumption rate very high because there is a special taste of Coca-Cola. The genuine Coca-Cola, not the fake Coca-Cola. So you see that when you're talking about human capital, we're talking about this value, the weight you attach. The more contribution you bring to a business in terms of knowledge and skills, the more you'll be highly successful. If it's not in the management of your chief, it's not in the doctor, chief, and the management manager of one of the subsidiaries, Chemicals and Steel Limited. Now, he was a very knowledgeable person. Because Namina has developed product immature of Wivokil. The best side, you know, is a sweet manga. He's the one who brought that project. And I will see how valuable he was. Unfortunately, he died. After a few years with us, Kuma is the one who brought the chemical combination of Wimbo. And he had one of our chemicals and Stephen and Mr. Wimbo, the University of Mona, which we were in another cross in my family. I remember this book actually. It's the value and the knowledge, the experiences and the capabilities. That and the motivation. Now, related to this, the value, the capability, the knowledge, the skills, the life experiences, related to this is what we call intellectual capital. Human capital, and now intellectual capital. And intellectual capital is very much protected. I don't imagine that for Elon Musk, for the intellectual capital. Elon Musk, the name